guys talk about some more Cells and the Thug. I'm just recording a bunch of episodes today because why not? Anyway, episode 9, Adelaide has a difficult task to transform her friends into a fashionable companions for the ball. Interesting. Okay. Let's see. So we do this chapter. I don't exactly remember what happens in these next two episodes, but we should be okay. I just finished updating the wiki with the new information that I learned about Jackie last episode, so that was interesting. Chapter 9, Let There Be a Ball. So, let's start from the beginning. You want to steal a ship. Not just a ship, but a whole galleon? That's right. And how, may I ask, will we do it? We'll do it, boldly and without fear. In bad times, there is no room for indecision and fear. You have to take risks. There are no simple solutions. Now we are like rats backed into a corner, and that's why I propose a daring plan. We'll use Diego's vanity. He's having a ball. Right on the ship. On the deck, of course. There's quite a lot of space. But if there are guests there, then the troops and the crew will have to stay on the shore. That's the problem. How are you going to break through this garrison? We will not break through. We'll go straight to the galleon. As guests. And picking the right moment, we'll take the control and sail the ship in the harbor. Meanwhile, the walrus will distract their attention. Then we'll pick up the rest of the crew and disappear into the vastness of the sea. It is impossible to move a ship like that on your own. Someone has to raise and adjust the sails, at least. And someone needs to be at the helm. That's why I would not go alone. It is frowned upon for ladies to go to the ball alone. Who to take to the ball? I'm pretty sure there's only three choices. So you got Sebastian, William, and Chris. They don't allow you to choose Jackie, because he's technically not a typical main ally, so that's interesting. I want to take Sebastian, but, is that harsh? I mean, a little bit, but he's the best, like, well-mannered, like, when you're in diplomacy route, yeah, he dances with you early in season one, and so you realize that he's actually a really good dancer, so he is likely the best choice. Like, he knows manners very well, whereas William and Sebastian, I mean, Chris, don't, because they didn't come from that sort of background. So I'm gonna choose the captain. I think the captain can keep his cool and has manners like no one else. This won't be my first ball, see what I mean? I cannot say it's something I want to do again, but I would do it for the cause. That would not change anything. Together you can cast off, at best. Well, it's evident that you do not understand how balls and receptions are arranged. A respectable couple would attend the ball without a servant. So you can choose Bobby, Jackie, and then choose him as a servant. And Seamus. Bobby is cute. He's fun. We didn't include him last time, but we also didn't include Seamus. I think we should. We gotta do Seamus. We gotta do Seamus. Oh, and these choices don't matter. Either way, they won't. They'll change, like, little bits about, like, because, of course, Chris has never danced before. William hasn't really danced either, so you have to teach them a bit more when it comes to the dancing. And different things will happen, so, like, Seamus and things like that, and whoever you choose, they get, like, different outfits and stuff like that. So that's about it as far as, like, changes for your story going for the future. But, you know, you can choose whoever, it doesn't really matter. But I'm gonna choose Seamus because it's funny. Why me? Because you ask the most questions. Well, you do have to think everything through to the last detail. And this is the second reason. You know everything about ships. And you'll be able to figure out how better to steal the ship during the ball. That makes sense. And you're a cute old man that no one will get suspicious about. Hey! I'm kidding. Well, we need to prepare. To practice manners and dance steps. I know one suitable place. Of course he does. It's like an old bar or something. This place is not bad. cozy and secluded. That's what I'm saying. But it's hardly possible to waltz here. There's just no space. Well, this is a no-brainer. We'll have to clean. So we'll get our hands dirty. Oof. Done. Oh, I think they cleared away the boxes and stuff. And I don't think those guns and knives were on the, swords were on the table before. Okay, let's get started. Although we should not attract attention to ourselves, you must understand that everything is a bit different at balls. At these events, the opposite is true. Everyone is trying to shine. And if you try to hide in the corners and avoid conversations, it will look suspicious. And of course, the main event will be the dance. Without music, it will be hard. Bobby will fix the situation. I know how you like to sing when nobody seems to hear you. So the time has come for your, as you thought, useless hobby. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. That's better. Well, let's start. Of course, I am out of practice. And that's what we're going to fix right now. And under Bobby's coarse but melodious muttering, Adelaide and the captain stood in a waltz step. I'm leading. And the dance began. Although the captain obviously did not remember all the subtleties of the form of the dance, he understood its spirit. He led Adelaide with a strong hand, making beautiful, sensual moves. After the dance, did not forget to bring the lady back to her place. Whoa! Okay. Little bit of jealousy going on there. Okay. Next to me. Do not worry. We'd better learn a livelier dance. You'll have to repeat the dance at the ball. For example, are you familiar with the paso doble? Oh, this also changes depending on which partner you have. I think with Chris, you learn the tango. I don't remember what dance you learn when you have William as your partner. Yeah. Of course. It requires a lot of space. That's okay. They'll make room. In the paso doble, the gentleman takes on the role of a bullfighter and the lady. I love this music. This is so fun. The role of the muleta, scarlet claw to tease the bull. A man does not just lead his partner. He twists and throws her from side to side. And the girl's skirts turn into a colorful cascade, hypnotizing the viewer. And Sebastian had very strong and agile hands, so adroitly and quickly controlling Adelaide that the girl felt dizzy. That was hot. Always at your service. But we have to bring our retinue up to standards. Now, let's take care of you. What's wrong with me? I can easily lead lofty speeches. I do not like serving. But for the sake of the mission, how do I put it? You look very rural. What do you mean? It's your beard. Don't go after my beard, Captain. Generally, she's right. No. That face is hilarious. I did not expect this from you. It's going to happen. No. How do I look? You haven't changed yet. Looked at his comrades. Great. He looks 20 years younger. Now all the skirts will be yours. The team barely held back their laughter. Give me the damn mirror. Well, that's it. Now I'm furious. They don't show it yet. I feel that everything will be... Oh, this is black magic, white magic. Perfect. And the beer will go back soon. Shiver me timbers. And now the finishing touches. What have we done? Oh, this is too good. A kilt? Seriously? Well, you need to justify your accent somehow. I've never worn such a thing in my life. My partner should also look worthy of me. Fancy. Fancy. She's super fancy, but yeah. Wouldn't go with this one. That looks cool. The best there is. Once upon a time, this belonged to my father. Jeremy adjusted it a little. I have not worn clothes in this class for a long time. What is Sebastian's background? Like, seriously. A feeling I forgot. You look like a count. Was he a count before? And now, each of us needs to rehearse his role properly, and the rest of you should find a suitable boat and prepare everything for boarding the ship when we set sail. Cool. A few days later, so the hour has come. Oh no, they didn't let me change my stuff. I don't think I'm wearing my tattoo though. I was gonna take that off, but it doesn't seem like that's necessary. Okay, good. Okay, so the hour has come. I'm leaving some things with you. Oh, yeah, because I can't wear the tattoo because I'm be wearing the mask. That's right. Take them with you to the boat. Aye, Captain. Are you forgetting anything? He looked at the ring with an expressive look. With it, you're instantly recognizable. Yeah. With a strong sense of foreboding, Adelaide took the ring off her finger. Goodbye. And hid it in her décolletage. Now we're ready. Adelaide felt uncomfortable being cut off from magic. He looks adorable. I like it. Come on. Path of strength. I did not get the invitation, so I'll have to go around. It's not the first time we had to hide. I hope we'll not ruin our outfits. For such operations, it will require completely different clothes. That's okay. We'll figure something out. And the team began to examine all the interesting paths carefully. The other day, the defense was weaker. Even the dungeon did not have such a guard. We can certainly break through with a fight. But in this case, we cannot even dream of an undercover capture on the ship. So we go back to our old ways. I like the stairs here. Decorated with the little flowers. Everything is so pretty. One distracts, the rest penetrate, and then help the one who distracts. I propose a candidate. I don't think the choice matters. But it's probably best if Sebastian's gonna be my date, then we let Seamus be the one to distract. Yeah, because we had Sebastian distract at the dungeon last time. Let's do Seamus this time. See what he's got. Oh, that's diplomacy. Oh, we're fine. Because I think we have just about enough. So we should have... I've chosen one strength choice this point. So we should have like 44. We only need one more. And it's not this chapter that we need it. I'll do it. Seamus, puffing and cursing under his nose, went towards the guard, and the team, retreating to the nearest corner, began to watch the show. Stop. No way. Making the most terrible face, Seamus began to swear flavorfully. What are you talking about? Meanwhile, Seamus' face turned red, and he brandished his fist menacingly. What are you saying? Hey, you! Stop! If Seamus did not swear in Gaelic, he probably would have been beaten long ago and dragged to prison. He's swearing in Gaelic? But since the soldiers did not understand what was going on, they were slow to react. And while they were staring disconsolately at the old man, Adelaide, trying not to make noise with her skirt, stealthily made her way behind the guards. Seamus, here you are. Is this your man? Yes. I sent this old fool for my gloves. Take him. I'm very sorry. He's not educated at all. And the whole team majestically went to the ship. Nice. Wow. That's the ship. A ship of inconceivably huge dimensions appeared before the girl's eyes, swaying peacefully on the water. Three full weapons decks bristling with large cannons. Five masts made from solid ancient pines. False panels protecting the crew from shrapnel. And of course, the gilded coating on the sides. Seamus was already whistling. I have to recruit assistants to support the management of such a monster. First, you need to get it out of the harbor. Ready to become the captain of such a vessel? I do not know. I'm afraid I do not have enough experience. That's fine. I'll help. So nice. What are you doing here? Oops. The lemur pulled out the hem of the girl's dress. How did you get in here? Are you bored? I know I promised to spend more time with you, but things are not over yet. Just a little longer and we'll be together again and free on a new ship. The animal began scrambling on the dress. You'll be too noticeable at the ball. Oh, we'll come with. You convince me. He'll be mischievous. I cannot stand your sad face. Get under the skirt. And adroitly clinging to the fabric, the lemur found his place on the inside of the hen. I hope he does not cause too much trouble. It's totally gonna be cheeky. Fancy. And full of dignity, hand in hand, our couple climbed the stairs to the ship. Luxury immediately caught the eye. A small orchestra on the bridge was playing relaxing music. Tables full of delicious courses were arranged on the sides. Garçons wandered everywhere, offering champagne and wine, and the deck was brimming with beautiful ladies and gentlemen in the most luxurious outfits. Just a moment of your attention. Oh my gosh. Adelaide's heart was about to jump out of her chest. Diego stood at an arm's length from her. The music subsided, and all the guests turned their masks to the governor. I greet you on my new flagship, Triumph. This is the beginning of a new era. The era that will put an end to piracy. An era when peace will be brought to these lands and waters. Diego's words were greeted with applause. No need, no need. I'm not doing this for myself. It's all for your sakes and the well-being of the crown. And a new wave of applause followed. But it will all start tomorrow. And today. Maestro, waltz. Gentlemen are inviting the ladies. Okay, so we're done part one. Okay, look, I thought I got my 44, so we need one more. So let's see what's gonna happen next. Let's go ahead and continue onwards. We made good time on that one. That was a pretty short chapter. Adelaide is head over heels into luxury, dancing and intrigue at the ball organized by Diego, but the ball is only a cover-up for the bold stealing of the warship. Okay. We're getting into the nick of things, and it's almost time for the finale, which is surely to be grand. But this episode is going to be full of intrigue and a lot of things going on the ship, so let's see. The show must go on. Adelaide's head was spinning from all the flavors of fine food and the sounds of beautiful love music. She spent so long in an environment of deprivation that she could hardly hold back. This world was tempting her to return to a carefree past. Gentlemen, invite the ladies to waltz. Will you? And the captain bowed courteously, according to the high standards of the aristocracy. Of course, I cannot refuse. And the music guided them. Adelaide became lost in the whirling motifs of the waltz. At some point, it seemed that nothing in her life has changed, and she is still the same noble woman with her career-free life and bright future. And the whole world around was spinning and spinning to the rhythm of the waltz. Sebastian's strong hands held her, not letting her grow dizzy. But the melody stopped, and the dance came to an end. And the couple parted, bowing deeply to each other. Sebastian quickly arranged his uniform and began to inspect the deck. And how do you feel, getting back to normal life? This life is no longer normal for me. And I do not want to go back to that. It's a pity that, they had to relive it. I mean, if you didn't want to, I mean, I feel pretty bad about that. That's fine. Consider this a job. How's the setting? Short story, Diego's a dunce. There are no sailors on board. Apparently not to inconvenience the lures with their faces. That's good. There are other difficulties. To control the steering wheel of such a huge helm, maneuvers will require more than one pair of hands. How'd you like the ball in your grace? Adelaide was a bit taken aback by this treatment. So this is the only dialogue that it changes, as far as how you're dressed and stuff like that. Yeah, mostly the dress is what makes the impression, but yeah, this is pretty much what changes how this woman sees you. She has mostly forgotten how to make small talk. And by the way, how is the weather in Spain? Why do you call me your grace? And I could not know about the weather in Spain. Stop pretending. Do you recognize me under the mask? You obviously took me for someone else. Of course, I did not know your name, but a dress like this can only be afforded by people close to the royal court. And most people know that an inspector was sent to Santo Domingo to look after the affairs of Don Diego. So how do you like the ball? The ball is... this is my magic ball, is it? Impressive. It's the first time I'm celebrating right on the deck of the ship. Me too. Chatting became more relaxed with a little glass of wine. It's all dust in your eyes. Pirates? Seriously? Do you think that such a ship is not capable of overcoming pirates? Or do you doubt the captain? Pirates have not been a problem for these seas for a long time now. No, they certainly do a lot of damage, but no armada can cope with the fog. Fog? Yes, the fog, which hides the dead. Do you believe in these stories? It's hard not to believe it. Interesting. Respectable gentleman, the woman pointed her fan at Sebastian, who was talking to some official. I think the problem with pirates can be solved by selling filibustering mandates at a more affordable price. Okay. Yeah, I forgot about that. He's over there, like, talking politics and crap. It's a little bit different. I think if you come with, like, Chris is the one I remember the most vividly. She doesn't really know anything about it, so she kind of mostly just, like, sneaks away to the snack bar. She's just, like, munching. Which is adorable, because she's so nervous to be here. Yeah, Rose Sebastian's a little bit different. He knows kind of, like, what to say and stuff like that. Is he your chosen one, or just accompanies you? We are, engaged. That's wonderful. So you will not claim Diego's heart? Do you intend to? Are there any other reasons for a lady of my status to appear at this reception? But you had quite an opinion just now about his hunt for pirates. But you did not hear how I spoke about how cleverly he managed to make a fortune on this island. But at what cost? This is not of prime importance. The main thing is that with his fortune, one can sail away from this fog, being a very well-off person. She's a little sneaky. Honestly, it's interesting because of I'm on the path of strength. I have no choice but to make her my enemy. So I might as well just call her sneaky now. I mean, I'm not going to be able to salvage this relationship. This wealth was built on blood, suffering, and deprivation. Of whom? Plebs? Plebs? After all, they were born to enrich the likes of you and me, and I did not understand the loyal attitude of the previous governor towards the blacks at all. I see I have a new enemy. Careful. You have no idea whom you're messing with. It's you who's clueless whom you talk to. Another word and you will learn how sharp and poisonous my teeth are. Oh wait, or did I have a choice? I don't remember. Can you be on the strength choice and make an ally of her? Let me go back, because I didn't see a banner pop up to tell me that Path of Strength. So we see what happened when we called her sneaky. Let's call her clever. Let me go back and redo this again. Hold on. All right, okay, we're back. So let's go ahead and choose clever. I'm amazed at your grasp. It's flattering to me, but there's no need to have a lot of cunning. He has practically been a widower for 5 years. And this means that in his lands, there is no woman who would have been equal to him. I'm sure that to win his treasures, I mean, heart, will not be difficult. Well, I assure you that I came here with some interest, but it's not connected with Diego's heart. You can be friends! It's not a path choice! That's interesting! I thought it used to be a path choice. I could have sworn it was. So you can befriend her even on the strength route. Or is it the black magic that made me an enemy with her? Interesting. Interesting. Okay. Yeah, let's make some connections. I think we should make some connections here. Yeah. Let's be friends. You've acquired a useful acquaintance. For if my plan succeeds, Diego will have to look for new allies, and then you will prove to be more useful than ever. And what kind of plan is that? Alas, it demands total secrecy. You will understand when it all starts, and I hope you play along. All right. Suddenly the music subsided. Musicians leafed through their scores with astonishment, as if unable to find the right page. The joyful animal brought Adelaide a pile of sheets. This is a gift for me. You thought it was something important, decided to give it to me? Oh, you're my little fool. The girl took the score from his paws. Go get some food. There's so much to eat here. But do not steal anything more. Then the joyful lemur trotted under the table. I found your pages here. It seems the wind blew them away, and the music started again. It seems that it's time to make it even a little bit spicier. Having whispered in the musician's ear, Adelaide descended on the deck. All right, it's time for that livelier dance that we talked about. Sebastian, hearing a familiar melody, tactfully broke free from all the conversations and took a step towards Adelaide, encouraging the crowd to part ways as he moved with long strides. The guests could not help but give in to such a serious and intense demeanor. Now then, shall we begin? Making a few picturesque torero steps towards Adelaide, he took her hand and spun her, and the dance began. I got you. I don't remember if I got us a picture of him smiling, so. Passionate, furious movements made the audience gaze in amazement. None of the guests were apparently ready for this, because they had not danced anything more complicated than a waltz for a very long time. Maybe to hell with this Diego. He looks like a wealthy man. A count for sure, I'd say. Only I wonder from which lands. I do not know who this scoundrel is, but this lady must be mine. If necessary, even through a duel. Their movements recall some vague memories. When the dance was over, the breathless couple turned to the public. A short pause and the guests were in a standing ovation so that the ladies nearly broke their fans. Thank you for your attention. And then Adelaide was intercepted by one gentleman. He took her away from other people's ears. Oh, Clive, what's up? I thought you were dead. Do we know each other? The dead man dragged you under the water. I love you. What? Why? What do you mean? Hold the phone. What do you mean I love you? It's just because I wasn't seeing anyone at the time. That's interesting. So, I didn't know how to unlock Clive's route either. Is this how you unlock his route? You don't date anyone? I will never forget the voice that dragged me away from the shackles of death. You. Much time has passed since that ill-fated day. But how did you manage to survive? You do not know how many times I've been asked this question. Then I will not bother you with it, but may I ask about something else? Ask? I've already heard about your complicated relationship with Diego. So why are you hiding and at the same time intruding in his very den? For now, it's my little secret. But I hope you will support me when everything happens. And then again, the waltz begins to play. May I invite you? Yeah. We're making allies here. It required a reliable ally. Yeah. And they swirled in the dance. He apparently had a sense of manners and elegance. Taking advantage of the intimacy of the dance, Adelaide bent to the ear of the colonist. How loyal are you to me? What kind of question is that? I see you're a man of honor. I saved your life. And it's time to return the debt. I'm at your disposal. Did you lose your ship? It was 5 years ago. Now I have a beautiful brigantine, the Black Queen. Does it have weapons? Yes, but not many. Enough for a distraction. What are you up to? I'll steal this galleon. Why are you so surprised? You should be happy. After all, with such a floating fortress, he will quickly be able to turn your colony into his. That makes sense. I'm in. And as soon as the music stopped, the colonists went off into the distance so as not to attract excessive attention. Huh. I wonder if there would have been a bit more romance there had you not joined with Jackie. I don't know. It still could come later. I don't know. That's very interesting. It's always interesting to find out, like, who you can romance. The priest suddenly appeared on the deck. What is he doing here? The Padre walked quickly to Diego. He looks worried. We need to overhear what's going on there. And furtively, as if by accident, Adelaide began to draw closer while drinking her wine. I cannot do this anymore. Can't you wait until tomorrow? You see, there's a celebration going on. I cannot hide it anymore. You are not the husband of Adelaide. I did not marry you. And her parents, even post factum, do not give their consent. Everything you have built is on lies. Lies that, by the way, are supported by my treacherous silence. I must put an end to this brutality before God. Have you spoken your piece? I will not let anyone spoil the celebration. And if you cannot wait to speak up, then tell it to the fish at the bottom of the sea. Diego pulled out a dagger. Don Diego. Good evening. He was about to kill him right there. Diego imperceptibly hit the dagger behind his back, and the Padre, pale with fear, decided to retire. How do you like the ball? Is that the only thing that interests you? You're right. I saw you dance. And you know, I'd like to invite you. Maestro, music. I invite you to dance. But it is he who, in the case of a hijacking, will give the order for an attack. And if I stall him, then, you know, I don't know. What do? I have a better idea. I'm tired of dancing. Waltz, waltz, and waltz. Who made the rules? Well, oh. Juan, of course. Tell him that he's terrible at selecting music. I'll also punish him. I thought you'd give me a tour of the ship. Of course. Diego put out his elbow and Adelaide hung on to it. Come on. You have an excellent taste for masks. You can see the hand of a master. Okay, so, This is where the mask comes into the dialogue. Okay, so the dress gets talked about by the lady, and he talks about the mask. Why should you hide your identity so carefully? Why do you think that is? Perhaps you are a dangerous criminal. You have no idea. Criminals do not have enough money for such a mask. Then who are you? Uncover your identity. The mask is what you need to preserve the intrigue. I understand. Interesting. Here's my cabin. Oh no. I don't want to come back here with you. I'm just writing down some notes, sorry. It's splendid. Isn't it too big for a ship? I like comfort and coziness. And now, Diego got on his knee. I want to give you this excellent. Damn it. Where is it? Meanwhile, under the tables, speaks Lemurian? I've overeaten. I have not eaten so much in my life. I've also found this thing. It's beautiful. Lady likes shiny things. I'm sure that this time she will not scold me. Oh my god. I forgot that happens. That's so cute. He got me a necklace. That's so nice. Have you lost something? Yes? Well, to hell with it. I'll find it later. And now, maybe we should start what we came here for. And Diego rushed towards Adelaide with open arms. Stop it. I'm ready, and I cannot be stopped. Oh, I'm counting on you to be untamed, but I suggest something more interesting. A rope appears in Adelaide's hands. Where'd she get the rope from? Have you ever been bound? Helpless. Surrendered. Being entirely at the will of a passionate woman. Which can, and most importantly will, do with you whatever she wants. To admit, never, but it sounds extremely exciting. Yes. Quickly, undress. What about you? You will have a front row seat to the show once you take your place. I'm ready. Lie down. Good. Adelaide furiously recalled the lessons of Seamus on working with rigging. Unfortunately, she's not served long on the Swallow, and the things she did on the Warwis were a little different, but did not take long to tie the knots. Come on. Only a moment. And with the light movement, she throws off the mask from her face. What? I should have known. I knew you were coming to the ball. How could I? Because any brilliance dazzles you. By the way, I almost forgot. Okay. And now, I'll make fun of you. Diego would not forget such a massive blow to his self-esteem. Adelaide took the candle out of the nearest lantern and fixed it over the bed so that... Drop. For now, enjoy the erotic massage. I still have a lot to do. Well, you know, sell your ship away. Take you hostage. As soon as we get out of the harbor, I'll come visit you. And taking Diego's pistol and sword, Adelaide's climbed onto the deck. Ladies and gentlemen, scare them. Society did not pay much attention to this cry. Bam. Not only did the shot stop the music, but also attract the necessary attention. This vessel is declared captured. Anyone who does not immediately jump overboard will become my captive. Oh my god. We will all die. Quickly, give up without a fight. Wings Helen! Yeah! Nice! It was a walrus entering the harbor under the black flag. Our friends did not disappoint. The little ship was going along the harbor line, and the defensive ships were wasting their gunpowder in vain, not having time to point their cannons on a fast-moving vessel. And the guns of the Black Queen started blasting. He kept his word. And now, we have guessed. From the other side. Adelaide glanced in the direction of the captain's hand and saw that the fog that was creeping onto the island. Is this a surprise or what? Okay, things have come up to a crazy climax, but there was a lot of intrigue, a lot of secrecy and making secret allies and everything like that, making fun of Diego, which is always a good time. I love seeing him frustrated. Sorry, he's a terrible person and I would do everything to make fun of him any chance that I get because that's hilarious. In either case, we're doing pretty good. We have our 45 strength, which we will need in the next episode for sure. So that's going to be great. So now we can be nice to our friends, but mean to most people. Yeah. And we got a little bit of white magic, of course. We're keeping that nice and strong. We're doing great. Oh, and we have a ship condition marker already, even though technically we haven't stolen the ship yet. I guess technically since our plan is already going well, they've already given us our new stat, so now there's now 6 stats to keep up with, which is great. Yeah, so get super excited for the finale because it's gonna be pretty awesome. We're gonna do episode 11 and then do the bonus episode, and that will finish off season 2 of Cells and Netflix. So hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, go ahead and show the video some love, and I will see you next time. Bye.